So thank you, Kevin.
All right, thank you. It's Kevin Riemenschneider, just so you're aware. Just want to point out a few things. One, I remember Luke when I was a freshman. It's been that long already, yes. And I first met Tyler when I was a sophomore. I don't know if you remember that. I was loudmouth in algebra. Yeah. Remember? Yeah. You're cheating off me. You don't remember that? No. No. I would also like to point out my parents were unable to attend today. My mother recently underwent, she was diagnosed with breast cancer last summer. She went through chemotherapy over the fall into the winter. And just this past Thursday, she finished radiation and is cancer-free. So, thank you. So her and my dad hopped the first plane to Vegas. Didn't invite me, but you know. So I brought that young, lovely woman sitting over there. So, all right. So, again, I'm a 2013 graduate of SMSU with a degree in history, and I'm currently student teaching in Hutchinson, Minnesota. Let's go back 10 years to 2004. I was in eighth grade and entering my first American history class taught by Mr. Kantak. Now, I've always had a passion for history, but now I had the opportunity to learn more. Kantak was respectful, energetic, and handled his classroom well. Years passed, and I was entering my sophomore year of high school, and I was entering 20th century American history. I had such high hopes for this class because so many events had happened over these years, but I found myself disappointed. This was the teacher who would throw in a DVD or a video, assign the same questions at the end of the chapter. That is not how you teach history, all right? It was at this time I knew I could teach better than this guy. It was at this time I knew I wanted to be a social studies teacher. Now, I was unaware of SMSU when I began my college search. I had my mind set on St. Cloud since it was where my cousins had attended college. When a few upperclassmates informed me about SMSU's education program and their small campus, I decided to take a tour. I felt very comfortable and relaxed when my mother and I toured here in the spring of 2009. This is when Sweetland Hall was first being built. I would be one of the first residents in Sweetland Hall. There's a reason why there's more RAs in there now. But I knew that this would be the place for me. My family told me two things as I entered college. Number one, do your homework in the library and you'll have more time at night to hang out with your friends. And number two, join clubs and associations to become more involved. I took their advice and became Sweetland Hall's third floor representative for Residence Hall Association. RHA is important to me because these are students who want to make a difference across campus. I represented for my fall semester and was elected vice president of RHA in the spring. I served until the following fall where I then became the Foundation Apartments representative. During that same semester, I joined Minnesota State University Student Association, or MSUSA, and helped represent SMSU. I attended a cultural diversity conference in St. Cloud, which helped me explore the different ethnicities amongst campuses across Minnesota. I lobbied at Minnesota's Capitol with other SMSU students to help lower interest loan payments. In late spring, I attended MSUSA's annual conference where we elected student officials to represent MSUSA at the Capitol. As I began my junior year, I joined the SMSU History Club. I started as a member, and in the fall, I was elected vice president. At the beginning of my senior year, I became president of the History Club. I was reelected in the spring and served until this past fall semester. My time spent in the History Club was most enjoyable, except Zach was there. Exactly there, isn't it? All of our members were energetic and worked hard. It is important that our community understands our state as well as our nation's past. We invited many guest speakers to come to our school, aided students in researching their History Day projects, judged student History Day projects, created a panel of professors in commemoration to John F. Kennedy's presidency this past fall, and finally have set up a five-year program on the Civil War. This past fall, I also was employed at the History Center here at SMSU, where I went through the journals of Joseph P. Resilian, one of the founders of SMSU. It was very interesting to learn how this university was designed. And during my final 2 years at SMSU, I also worked as a groundskeeper for the school. Since I grew up on a farm, I enjoyed working outside. I worked with the nicest group of co-workers a student could ask for. When my last day came, they threw me a surprise dinner. They told me how they would miss me, and I replied, "I've taught you everything I know. You guys would do just fine." And since my departure, they've been doing, I guess, all right. I applied and was awarded the History Scholarship during my junior year and the Nick Roberts Memorial Scholarship during my senior year. Both scholarships have aided me along the path to a higher education, and I'm extremely grateful to those who have accepted me. My scholarship gave me the opportunity to return to SMSU and complete my classes in order to obtain my teaching licensure. Words cannot describe my experience at SMSU. I'd accomplished so much, met and made great friends, and received an education that will assist me in my future goals. I plan to continue on the path to teaching, and in the years to come, I wish to attain my master's in history. I've always had a passion for history. It was my comfort zone during my college career. Every night I would sit down and read a book about John F. Kennedy, Abraham Lincoln, or some battle in World War II. I keep striving to learn more. I will leave you now with this quote from Robert F. Kennedy. Few will have the greatness to bend history itself, but each of us can work to change a small portion of events. And in the total, of all those acts will be written the history of this generation. I made my own history at SMSU, and I hope that the students in this room and the students to come will create theirs too. Thank you.